Hi, this is Dr. A with the medical terminology video, and we're going to look at diagnostic procedures for the nervous system. So we're going to start with clinical lab tests. So a cerebral spinal fluid analysis, or CSF analysis, it's an examination of the spinal fluid, and it is done to detect infections in the blood, infections and blood in the fluid. So if there's a brain bleed, or if there's bacterial infection or a viral infection, is typically collected in these clear tubes that come with the lumbar puncture kits, and they're filled with 1 or 2 mils of spinal fluid in each tube, and then each tube is used for different types of tests. Brain scan, so this is diagnostic imaging. It's an image of the brain that's taken after an injection of radioactive isotopes into the bloodstream. A cerebral angiography is an x-ray of the blood vessels of the brain after the injection of radioopaque dye. And an echoencephalography is a recording of ultrasonic echoes in the brain. A myelogram is an x-ray record of the spinal cord, and myelography is an x-ray of the spinal canal following an injection of radioopaque dye. A PET scan, or positron emission tomography, is an image of the brain cut along a plane that is produced by measuring gamma rays that are emitted after injection with radioactive glucose. The glucose uptake by the tissue is indicative of metabolic activity. And so, for example, if there's a tumor in there, tumors have high metabolic activities, that tumor will glow on the PET scan. Babinski's reflex is a reflex test that reveals nervous system lesions. It is performed by stroking the sole of the foot. An electroencephalogram, or an EEG, is a record of the patient's electrical patterns. In electroencephalography, or EEG also, is a recording of the electrical activity of the brain by placing the electrodes on the scalp. It is also used in sleep studies. A lumbar puncture is a puncture with a needle in the lumbar area to remove the spinal fluid for examination or to inject anesthesia. And a nerve conduction velocity measures the speed at which an impulse travels along the nerve and reveals nerve damage. And then this illustrates a lumbar puncture. Typically here go between L4 and L5. So way below the end of the spinal cord, which ends at L2 over here, and in an attempt to collect the spinal fluid here in this epidural space here. So we call it an epidural, but they poke in there trying to get through, poke through the dura mater and get the spinal fluid. So that should wrap up our diagnostics. There we go, and I'll see you in the next video.